Okay. Hello. How's everybody today? You're gonna have to let me know if the audio's okay. No webcam for now, cause Molly is working. I don't know if don't know if that means I'm too low. So you're gonna have to just I have to actually turn off this music and pay attention. Let me just adjust that and see if yeah, it seems like those levels are fine. Okay, so now we get Wondrous Tales. Good. How many second chances do I have? This is sick. Oh god, Limitless Blue. Okay. This. Trying to get a queue for our Paradigm's Reach to pop so I can get equipment for my Gunbreaker. That doesn't really feel like it's something like that's happening anytime soon. Just withdraw. Sucks that I've waited that long. Oh well. It was Bowl of Embers, World Eater, and Striking Tree. Leader, Limitless Blue, Bowl of Embers, and Striking Tree, yep. Oh. First thing is to be Wondrous Tales. Usually an extreme fight that you see people, but because of doing an unsync, I can use them in like a minute. gotta do all of the scripted stuff before you get there. Oh wait, no, I got action.
Okay.
Sun Soul World Eater. This is why I can't wait to have Machinist to 80 so I can do the that Evan cast bars. Yeah, I'm thinking no! Yes, you know that. Now the fun one, and by fun I mean not fun at all. This one you can do solo, but it's weird. This one I have to pay attention to because there's two ads that if they go together, if they hang out together, they pretty much become impossible to kill, even at level 80. Supposed to hit it earlier. allow you in extra range, you have to stand. Here's the one I get to burn down somewhere. Be able to salvage this and get this other one down. So. Those two are bad. Okay, we're good. As long as you burn one down fast enough. it's not too bad once you pay attention to those two guys. As long as you pay attention for those two guys. One's way less of a pain than those other ones. Which is why I don't have anybody else to do. Once we've done all the extremes that we can do by myself, I just go back and use my second chance points. Just do the easy ones. take Shiva because Shiva's pretty easy to do. Three more times. Oh, my seal's been horrible. Free XP. looks no whammies. That's whammies. Sad face. It's fine. It's fine. It's not the end of the world. You don't get any lines. Swap over to the class and off the XP on. Got like a half a level. And enough tombstones. To get my accessories. Machinist all level for 60. Wait, do I have enough?
Not enough poetics.
There's just enough water for accessory set, holy shit. Okay, we'll wait 2 minutes and then our actually probably just queue for me inside the area, and by the time this pops it will be 11. Thank you. Be right back. No, it was right on that at least. The funny thing is, as soon as I go to start putting faith to with the relic step that I have for Red Mage, because this is a relic step I can actually fucking do while I'm waiting for shit, it's gonna pop. Okay. Roll waiting list number one. Average waiting time, 7 minutes. That is it. The lie detector determined that that was a lie. Oh, there it is. That I knew before the Faden that it was Praetorium. Thank you. check, let me check. actually check to see what burn decks are playing right now. We're back at 19 lands? Palace of the Lord. Shuffling cards like right in my microphone. It's like not picking it up pretty much at all. I think that's absolutely ridiculous in the coolest way. Like, thank you. Oh, Nero. As soon as his hammer falls from the sky, that's when I'll get ready. There should be 19 wins. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 18, 19. Yep. Where's my binder? I gotta find a lightning helix. Voice acting of ARR, gotta love it.
Tell me, for whom do you fight? Garcia. Eorzea's unity is forged of falsehoods. Its city-states are built on deceit, and its faith is an instrument of deception. It is not but a cobweb of lies. To believe in Eorzea is to believe in nothing. In Eorzea, the beast tribes often summon gods to fight in their stead. Though your comrades only rarely respond in kind. Which is strange, is it not? Are the 12 otherwise engaged? I was given to understand they were your protectors. If you truly believe them your guardians, why do you not repeat the trick that served you so well in Cartano and call them down? They will answer, so long as you lavish them with crystals and gorge them on ether. Your gods are no different from those of the beasts. Icons, everyone. Except but this, and you will see how Eorzea's faith is bleeding the land dry. Nor is this unknown to your masters, which prompts the question, why do they cling to these false deities? What drives even men of learning, even the great Louis Soir, to grovel at their feet? The answer? Your masters lack the strength to do otherwise! For the world of man to mean anything, man must own the world. To this end, he hath fought ever to raise himself through conflict, to grow rich through conquest. And when the dust of battle settles, it is ever the strong
and this is my fifth
who dictate
class
the
raising
fate
me.
Of the weak. Single path is open to the infinite ruler, that of false worship, a path which leads to innovation and death. Only a man of power can rightly steer the course of civilization, and in this land of creeping mendacity, that one truth will prove its salvation. Come, champion of Eorzea. Face me! Your defeat shall serve as proof of my readiness to rule! It is only right that I should take your realm, for none among you has the power to stop me! Allow me then, hero.
Hero.
To do that.
Do that.
Which you will not.
He takes out the sword, points it at us, just to put it back.
Blessing of light that confounds you.
Lahabria.
Your foe acts under the protection of the crystal he bears.
So, this is what empowers him.
Sorry, we got this,
beyond mortal limits.
If
you are to prevail, the hammer of darkness must needs be brought to bear upon the shield of light. And so it shall, for the Ultima weapon is host to a power of which you are as yet ignorant.
Speak plainly, Asian.
The heart of Sabik. It is the weapon's core, an enigma whose surface even the vaunted scholars of ancient Alec failed to scratch. The magic within has lain dormant for eons.
Of what magic do you speak?
A spell without parallel.
Ultima.
I sought the life force of the primals for no other reason but to quicken the core. For the true power of the Ultima weapon lies within its now beating heart.
Lahavrea, what have you done?
No more than was necessary.
Necessary.
For my god to be reborn.
Damn you, Asya.
The hour is at hand. Behold but a sliver of my god's power. From the deepest pit of the seven hells to the very pinnacle of the heavens, the world shall tremble. Unleash Ultima! Such devastation! This was not my intention! Oh, Heidelin, it seems the task of keeping your champion alive has exhausted what strength you had left. Van Belsar, your enemy's shield is broken. The rest I leave to you.
We will speak later, Asian. But first, I must deal with you. The question of who is mightier remains. Come, adventurer. Let us find the answer together.
Thank you.
Heed me. The subjects of a weak ruler must needs look to a higher power for providence, and their dependence comes at a cost to the realm. The misguided elevate the frail, and the frail lead the people astray. Unless a man of power wrests control, the cycle will never be broken. You of all people must see the truth in this. You who have the strength to rule.
Pathetic. You boasted of unrivaled power. You were entrusted with the ultimate weapon, the ultimate magic. And still, you failed. So much for the glory of man. The growing imbalance afflicting the planet must be redressed. If it is permitted to worsen, the very laws of existence, both etheric and physical, will be warped beyond all recognition. Know you the root of this corruption? Hydaelyn! Like a parasite, she must be burned out if the planet is to recover. And not but the return of the one true god will ensure her complete excision. Yet, to pave the way for the Master's return, a chaotic confluence of untold proportions must needs be brought about. And that will necessitate the presence of the primals. Needless to say, both you and your Scion accomplices cannot be suffered to interfere in this endeavor. You will not leave this place alive.
Wildfire. I'm like barely gonna get a wildfire. See the player mom as a machine is, that's so fucking funny. I just find it hilarious every time I get a comm as a DPS. Oh god. I have machine assist 61, this means I can get Void Arc. Oh god, please no. Please just give me Labyrinth of the Ancients. I guess I can go over there and check to see if there's anybody else over there. I definitely can't fight this on my own. This warp I keep telling me. Well, I got what I deserved. Oh, no. probably get like 2 seconds to adjust myself. Nope. It was 2 seconds now, I guess. It really gives you enough time to leave. Could have went worse. Oh, I know this is all the darkness. I was like, oh wait, do I have drill? I was getting all excited. Like, do I have drill? I do not have drill. I can be all sad, but I don't know. Definitely sad face that I do not have to. Are we attacking it already? Everything. party definitely could do some healing. Healers are definitely strong. Except your raise tank, come on. Oh, for fuck's sake. Belt? No. No belt. So tired, how are you? Same. Our tank is still dead. Tank is a machinist. Thanks. seems he's also really tired. I mean, and feeling. Smack it for a minute while we're waiting for the ads to come. Our healers are having a real problem staying alive right now. Not too bad considering. That's kind of cool. Of course, I roll like garbage on it. You know how it be.
Thank you.
Oh god. I forgot about the I forgot about the black marker. I'm just getting hit by everything. Killing me in that archer is the same idea. I was like, yeah, you might not want to stay in front of her. Did the Game War at the Game of the Year nominations come out? Let me look at those really quick. Deathloop, It Takes Two, Dread, Psychonauts. Who do I think is going to win? It's probably going to be Village. I personally would love for Dread to win. And this other... SMT. Any of them can win. Deathloop, as much as I loved Deathloop, it was like... it's not as good as... It's not as good as Dread. Or how good as I've heard Rift Apart and Village are. It Takes Two is good, just not Game of the Year good. And SMT5... Cyberpunk is on there. Pause, Cyberpunk is on there. Oh, I'm dead. Cyberpunk is on there. I want SMT5 to win this category. Scarlet Nexus, I tried it because it's on Game Pass. It's okay. It's not what I thought it was going to be, but it's okay. Obviously, a lot of people like Rise, but I'm hoping SMT5 can win. It's hilarious that Cyberpunk is still on there. No. Do you know what date that is, Paz? Like the actual awards are? December 9th. I don't have my schedule for next week, so I don't have my schedule for that week. Only Seraphim and Raids of the Dying do it. I have 9. stop a keyboard. Just farming memories, so. There's no harm in hanging out for a bit. I don't even care if we get some extras because I can do it for my third relic weapon. Well, I was just too slow to set it up. Maybe I can ask, we can ask Sean if we can collab stream it at the moment. I figure we likely are both going to be watching it. And we may both stream it. Three more. Oh, I think. First, gotta check my schedule. I gotta make sure I'm not too ever regretful of Falcon 9. Is that an 18 or that's an 18? I gotta get rid of this keyboard. Thank you.
I'll be back.
Oh, sick. Nice. I was actually gonna make lunch and I ended up just eating Pop Tarts. Is there a trailer? And if there is, would you mind posting it in chat? If you would be so kind, pause. It's just a tweet, that's fine. You don't have to post it. Yeah, it's ridiculous. But if there is an actual trailer, actual factual trailer, Game Awards has literally just been live, like, live tweeting everything. Hold on. They've been, like, live tweeting all of the nominees. For, like, everything. Oh, is this still, like, somewhat live? Okay, there's an actual, like, video. Cool.
Hi everyone, I'm Jeff.
Dear Green Day was there, it was so weird.
Awards nomination special. We are so excited that our 8th annual show will be streaming live
here,
the Microsoft Theater on December 9th with an in-person audience. Lots of big world premieres and spectacular live music too, including the return of the Game Awards Orchestra live on that very stage. In the weeks ahead, we will tell you much more about the show. But right now, we are honored to reveal this year's nominees in more than 30 categories, which you can vote on starting right now at thegameawards.com. So, let's get started. For Best Performance, the nominees are Erica Mori, Life is Strange, True Colors. Giancarlo Esposito, Far Cry 6. Jason Kelly, Deathloop. Maggie Robertson, Resident Evil Village. And Ozioma Aka, Deathloop. In the category of Best Multiplayer, the nominees are Back for Blood, Knockout City, Monster Hunter Rise, New World, It Takes Two.
I hope It Takes Two wins. I hope It Takes Two wins.
The nominees are Apex Legends, Call of Duty Warzone, Final Fantasy XIV, Genshin Impact, and Fortnite.
I'm a little biased, though.
The nominees for Best Art Direction are...
I'm a little biased.
Kena, Bridge of Spirits. Psychonauts 2. Ratchet & Clank, Rift Apart. And The Artful Escape.
I want Deathloop to win, but I know Kena's gonna win.
Cyberpunk 2077. Deathloop.
Why?
Dear Replicant, version 1.22474487139.
Near!
Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy. And The Artful Escape.
I hope it's near, even though it won't win.
Nominees are Deathloop, Forza Horizon 5, Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart, Resident Evil Village, and Returnal.
I hope it's Returnal.
possibility presented by Chevrolet.
Returnal for the by making our industry available to for the stuff they did with the controller.
By a special committee of accessibility experts. The nominees are Far Cry 6, Forza Horizon 5, Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy, Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart, and The Veil, Shadow of the Crown.
I don't know anything about accessibility, so I can't say.
Best story in a game. The nominees are Deathloop, It Takes Two, Life is Strange, True Colors, Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy, Psychonauts 2.
Okay. Can we just say for best narrative?
For Impact recognizes a thought-provoking game with a profound pro-social meaning. And Psychonauts.
The game where the characters think the best idea to get them changed back is to make their daughter cry, and therefore murder her favorite stuffed animal, is nominated for best narrative at the Game Awards. Just let that sink in for a second.
Games for Impact recognizes a thought-provoking game with a profound pro-social meaning. The nominees are
Life is Strange is a nominee.
Boyfriend Dungeon.
Boyfriend Dungeon.
Life is Strange, True Colors,
Weird.
And No Longer Home.
I know nothing about those games.
Game celebrates a game made outside of the traditional publishing system. The nominees are 12 Minutes, Death's Door, Kena, Bridge of Spirits, Inscription, and Loop Hero.
I hope Inscription wins.
This
I heard.
Is where our nominees will be seated in just a few weeks. But for now, let's get back to the nominations. For best mobile game presented by Verizon.
I like how they're like, I like how they're not wasting time.
League of Legends Wild Rift, Marvel Future Revolution, and Pokemon Unite.
I hope it's Pokemon Unite.
Here we are presenting an award for best community support. The nominees are Apex Legends,
Final Fantasy 14,
Final Fantasy 14,
yes,
Fortnite, and No Man's Sky.
I'm a little biased.
The debut indie game recognizes a development studio that published its first ever game in 2021. The nominees are Kena, Bridge of Spirits, Sable, The Artful Escape, The Forgotten City, and Valheim. Best VR/AR game.
I have the
nominees are Hitman 3.
I wish Night Service was the only one you can play. That's fair.
Echo 2, Resident Evil 4, and Sniper Elite VR. For Content Creator of the Year.
Oh, RE4 is going to win that.
Green, Foosley, Gallus, Ebi, and The Graph. For Best Actor,
I only vaguely know who Dream is.
2021 are Back for Blood, Chivalry 2, Deathloop, Far Cry 6, and Returnal.
Was kind of a slow year. Deathloop's going to win that.
The nominees are Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy, Metroid Dread,
Dread.
Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart.
Dread.
Resident Evil Village. And
Dread.
Psychonauts 2.
Dread. Dread was amazing.
Role-playing game. The nominees are Cyberpunk 2077.
Why?
Monster Hunter Rise. Scarlet Nexus. Shin Megami Tensei 5. And Tales of Arise. Now, before
Listen
we get to
five.
Our next categories, let's take a look at what's next in gaming. Of course, you can expect some big world premieres at the show this year, both brand new game announcements and announced ones.
I hope SMT5 wins. Rise will probably win, but I hope SMT5 wins.
Presented by Prime Gaming. Elden Ring.
Elden Ring.
Ragnarok. Horizon Forbidden West.
Elden Ring will win.
Sequel to The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild and Starfield.
Elden Ring will win.
Game Awards in 2014, Dragon Age Inquisition from BioWare won Game of the Year. And this month, Prime Gaming members can
at least we won't be weird. I'm sad.
Ultimate Edition from Remedy, which was nominated for Game of the Year back in 2019. When we're back here on
I'm sad we don't have a Smash reveal.
More new offers and free games for Prime Gaming members. To grab those games, you can head right now to gaming.amazon.com. And now back to the categories. For Best Fighting Game, the nominees are
Guilty Gear,
Demon Slayer, Guilty Gear Strive,
Guilty Gear Strive,
Guilty Blood Type Lumina, Nickelodeon All-Star Brawl.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Fighter 5 Ultimate Showdown.
Are you fucking kidding me? The Nickelodeon Smash Bros. Clone is nominated for Best Fighting Game at the Game Awards. What? Nickelodeon yes meme votes, please. I want Guilty Gear to win. Guilty Gear is actually a good game.
Now we are up here on stage where we will hand out trophies and reveal this year's biggest world premieres on December 9th. Next up, Best Family Game. Those nominees are It Takes Two, Mario Party Superstars.
I wouldn't really call It Takes Two a Super Mario 3D World family game.
And WarioWare. Get it together.
Probably Super Mario. It's probably Mario Party.
Bowser's Fury and WarioWare. Get it together. In the category of Best Sim Strategy Game, the nominees are Age of Empires 4, Evil Genius.
Pokemon Snap is not a family game, zero multiplayer. I know.
Humankind, Inscription, and Microsoft Flight Simulator. The category of Best Sports Racing Game, those nominees are
Forza 5,
2021, FIFA 22, Hot Wheels Unleashed, Forza Horizon 5, and Riders Republic. Now, a look at our esports categories, starting with the best esports game presented by Grubhub.
Can I pass?
Call of Duty, CSGO, Dota 2, League of Legends, and Valorant. For best esports athlete, the nominees are Collapse, Simple, Showmaker, Tens, and Simp. For best esports team, Atlanta FaZe.
I don't care about
League of Legends.
I don't care about esports.
Dota 2 and Sentinels Valorant. The best esports coach nominees are
Oh my god.
Crowder, NA, Coma, and Silent. Esports events still have
What is it with the What is it been with the esports? What is it with the esports nicknames?
World Championship. Valorant Champions Tour Stage 2 Masters, PGL Major Stockholm 2021, and PUBG Mobile Global Championship 2020. And now, our final two categories. For Best Game Direction, which recognizes outstanding creative vision and innovation in game direction and design, the nominees are Deathloop, Psychonauts 2, It Takes Two, Returnal, and Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart.
I hope Returnal wins, even though it won't.
On behalf of the jury, comprised of more than 100 global media and influencer outlets, I am proud to announce the six nominees selected for outstanding creative and technical excellence. The nominees for Game of the Year are Deathloop from Arkane Studios, It Takes Two from Hazelight, Metroid Dread from Mercury Steam and Nintendo, Psychonauts 2 from Double Fine Productions, Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart from Insomniac,
Please, Dread.
Resident Evil Village from Capcom.
Yeah, no, literally all of them deserve it. Yeah, but I want Dread.
What game do you think should walk?
Dread. Dread should walk away with Game of the Year. I don't care.
It won't, but I want it to. It will not.
You know, some of those decisions on the family games.
I'm just like, it's a Nintendo game, it definitely counts.
That's what it's just like big, it's a Nintendo game energy.
I also feel called out.
Ken Shevlock is voicing Spider-Man in the new Avengers game. Wait, they're doing like Spider-Man DLC for the Avengers game? Just fucking get Yuri Lowenthal in there and just, and tie the Marvel games from Insomniac to why everything that they've done with that is. Everything that game is just in the trash for them. Okay, 138. Okay. Thank you. can't stop doing these tokens. Oh, the goat's still 60. It's more Grotten. 1500. Lavender oil 95.
Is that for 92?
92. I don't care if you get rid of this stuff anyway.
You want to work?
One time. Oh, there is a trailer.
Hang on.
I didn't know that there was a trailer.
Wake up! It's time for a new announcement from the Game Dodecahedron Company. Introducing the Game Dodecahedron Create and Play Channel. This exhilarating channel provides access to all new ways to play. You put in a disc, it goes, and it brings you straight to your selection in no less than 1,000, 1,035,000. Be the first in your galaxy to have the new Game Dodecahedron Create and Play Channel.
Supposed to be a joke on the GameCube, that's really funny.
Her and I, we have a score to settle. You think I've forgotten what she's done to me? All on that cursed day. Look, it's complicated, but she didn't have to treat me that way. I was her prince, and she was my princess. Everything was going so well. Or so I thought.
Okay. What?
So, are you ready? Let's go pay Tessa a little visit.
Oh, it's multiplayer.
The curse has been released. I'd watch your back if I were you.
Find them. Do not let a single one survive.
Oh.
Do not step now. I want every single one of them cursed.
This is getting exciting. Welcome to my humble abode. Did you bring any new shiny crowns?
I want!
Brand new flares and dyes? Oh, they're really cute. They're really cute.
She's just as extreme as ever.
Man, that actually looks really cool.
That actually looks really cool. Anyway, I think I'm good for right now. I think I'm gonna call it a day for now. I'll be back streaming later today with the race with Ryan, and then I'll probably be doing some SMT5 after that. Is it bad? I'm most excited for the new costumes. No, I want a bit of a break from streaming before we do the race. Go take a nap. So we'll see you later tonight. And see ya.